Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I made this caricature a cartoon effect in Photoshop. At the end of the tutorial, with the power of smart objects, you will be able to reapply the whole effect on any image with a couple of clicks. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the caricature effect. Let's start by creating a new document. Change both width and height to 2200 and 1600. Then click Create. From File, place Embedded. Import your image. Press Enter to confirm, then go and pick the Quick Selection tool. Start selecting your object like that. Let's speed up this part. Please take your time to adjust your selection for a better result. After finishing your selection, create a layer mask out of it. Right-click your layer and choose Rasterize Layer. Then right-click the mask and choose Apply Layer Mask. Now as you can see, we have a fully isolated layer. Now pick the Lasso tool and start selecting the head like that. With your layer selected, press Ctrl and J to take it to a new layer. Now select the bottom layer, then press Ctrl and T and make it smaller. And for the head, make it bigger. Now I want to connect this big head to the body. Just select the head layer and go to the Liquify filter. And with the Forward Warp tool, start moving from the neck edges like this. Now pick the Brush tool with black foreground color. Select the head layer and make a mask for it. Right-click and decrease brush hardness first. And with the mask selected, start painting over the neck edge to blend it with the body. Now make a solid color layer below both two layers. Pick any color you want, then click OK. With your layer selected, hold the Shift key and select the top layer to select all three layers. Right-click them and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now with your layer selected, go to the Liquify filter again. Under the Face Aware Liquify section, Photoshop will recognize all human faces in your image. And it will give you some good settings to manipulate them. This updated Liquify filter is available only in all Photoshop versions above CC 2015. If you're using an older version, please consider updating it to be able to use this feature. Now, let's change the eyes setting. Just increase the eye size, height, and width to the given values. And also increase both eye tilt and distance. And for the nose, change both nose height and width to 100. And for the mouth, increase both upper and lower lips and leave all values 0. And finally, for the face shape, change it to minus 50, minus 10, minus 70, and 10. Then click OK. Here is the final result. And now let's move on to the next step. Step 2. Create the cartoon effect. First, select your layer, then press Ctrl and J to duplicate it 2 times. Rename them from bottom to top like that. Hide the top 2 layers and select the effect layer. And from Filter, Sharpen, choose the Smart Sharpen filter. Change values to 200, 1.5, and 0. As you can see, this will increase the overall sharpness of your image. Since we are working with smart objects, all filters will be applied as smart filters. Now with your layer selected, go to Filter, Stylize, and choose Oil Paint Filter. Change values to 5, 3, 0.1, and 0, and uncheck Lightning. If your oil paint filter is grayed out or doesn't work, please check the video description for a proper solution. Now go to Filter Gallery, and under the Artistic folder, choose the Poster Edges filter. This will divide the skin tone to different levels like this. Just change values to 0, 0, and 2. Then click OK. Now go to Filter, Blur, Surface Blur. Change Radius to 15 and Threshold to 7. This will make the skin smoother. With your layer selected, reapply the oil paint filter again. Keep all values as previous and click OK. Finally, go to Filter, Sharpen, and apply the Unsharp Mask. Change amount to 140, radius to 5, and threshold to 2. Then click OK. Here is the before and after. And now let's move on to the next step. Step 3. Add the details. First, select the details layer and unhide it. And with your layer selected, go to Filter and choose Filter Gallery. Choose the Poster Edges filter and change values to 4, 4, and 6. Then click OK. Apply the oil paint filter. But this time, increase stylization to 10 and leave all other values as they are. Now change blend mode to overlay and decrease the opacity to something below 30%. As you can see, this will add some little detail lines to enrich your final cartoon effect like that. Now with your layer selected, press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. And with your duplicated layer selected, change blend mode to pin light. Double-click the filter gallery to open it. Change its values to 6, 7, and 6. Then click OK. Increase layer opacity to see what's going on. If you zoom in, you will see some black outlines added to your final effect. Now decrease the opacity to a value below 50%. Rename the layer Outlines, and let's finish the last layer. Just unhide the skin layer and select it, then go to Filter, Other, and choose High Pass. Change Radius to 1.5, then click OK. And change Blend Mode to Overlay. Now select the four layers by holding the Shift key, then drag and drop on the group icon to group them. Give a name to the group, and let's move on to the final step. Step 4. Extra tips. As you can see, you can add some adjustment layers depending on your image if you like. But for now, let's see how to reapply the whole effect on a new image. Just open any smart object by double-clicking its thumbnail like this. Once you're inside your smart object, import your image right here. Just go to File, Place Embedded, and choose your image. Repeat the process of step 1 to enlarge the head, and after you finish, press Ctrl and S to update your effect. Now get back to your main document, and that's it. If you want a more detailed effect, just go to the image size and increase your document size by 500 pixels. Click OK and wait a little bit. And if you decrease your image size, you will get a low detailed result like this. This is how to control the intensity of your cartoon effect. Finally, you can change the style of your final effect by showing and hiding this filter. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more tutorials. Thanks for watching.